Hello, my friends. Let's continue our journey on IMO 2020. The next one is a number theory problem about arithmetic and geometric mean. Let's take a look on the statement. We are given a deck of n cards, where a positive integer is written on each card. The deck has the following property that the arithmetic mean of the numbers on each pair of cards is also the geometric mean of the numbers on some collection of one or more cards. The question is to determine for which number n does it follow that the numbers on the cards are all equal. We start by recalling that the geometric mean is always smaller than the arithmetic mean. In particular, if the number a and b are distinct, then all these inequalities are strict. This means if we want to make the geometric mean matches the arithmetic mean, we need to add some large numbers into this product. More precisely, if the average of a and b is the geometric mean of some numbers, then necessarily one of these numbers is strictly larger than a. This simple fact is indeed the key of the proof. Let's see how we proceed. We denote the numbers on the deck by a1 to an. It is easy to see that if they have a common factor d, then dividing all the elements by d does not change the property of the deck. So with our loss of generality, we assume that the greatest divisor of a1 to an is 1. And also, we impose an increasing order, that a1 is smaller than a2, smaller than a3, and so on. Now, if the numbers are not all equal, then an must be larger than 1, and we take a prime divisor p of an. The claim is that p divides all the elements of ak, and we prove it by descending induction. The initialization at k equals to n is obviously true by definition. So let's assume that k is true and consider k minus 1. By the descending order, we know that ak minus 1 is not larger than ak. If it is equal, then we are done. If ak minus 1 is smaller than ak, we know that the arithmetic mean of ak and ak minus 1 is the geometric mean of some collection of ai. Therefore, one of the right-hand side is strictly larger than ak minus 1, which belongs to the set ak to an. Now from the induction, p divides any number between ak to an. So p divides the product on the right-hand side, which is the average of ak minus 1 and ak to the power m. This implies that p divides the sum, and therefore p divides ak minus 1. So this allows us to continue the induction, and which gives us p divides all the elements of ak. And obviously, this is not going to hold because we have assumed that all the ak has the greatest common division 1. So this is a contradiction. Therefore, for any n, it holds that the numbers on the cards must be equal. Voila, this is it. I hope you enjoy the solution. This is Red Peak. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next time. Bye bye.